fabric structure to handloom and textile technology. The fabric production. Here we are seeing the type of fabric is called resin cords. In the resin cords, Leno and plain weave are forming stripes in the fabric surface that is called the resin cord effect. In these fabrics, some of the ends form group of ends forming plain weave structures and group of ends forming Leno structures. In the Leno structures, normally the standard ends more number of fine threads are the standard threads are more coarser. Standard threads are more coarser with different colors. With different colors, different color of crossing end and the standard end. So this type of production, more number of threads in the standard end will form the cord effect, vertical cord effect in the fabric, and that cord effect may controlled by the crossing ends. Controlled by the crossing ends, the crossing ends hold the standard threads in the fabric, and it form the cord effect in the fabric surface. The resin cords are wide of 6 mm have been successfully woven in flat steel dupe assemblies. Heavy cord lines are thus produced, which on account of contrast in color with ground warp and weft appear to be formed in the extra weft. This will like us extra weft thread effect. The crossing warp requires to be very much longer than the standard warp because that the crossing ends passes nearby 4 standard threads. That's why we need more lengthy yarn to produce cross ends, more lengthy cross ends to produce this kind of fabrics. Next one is net Leno structures. These are all form net or spider Lenos. These are all called a net Leno or spider Leno. In this, the crossing ends are mostly floated on the surface of the plain cloth and interlaced with the picks, so as to form waved lines or the zigzag effect in the fabric surface. Further, the style one, in the first style, standard ends are taken in 2 heels to work these ends in the plain order. So the heeled, the standard ends are taken into 2 heel frames and working with the plain order. Under set of 2 heel is required to produce plain stripe in the other places. Each crossing end is drawn from left to right of 4 standard ends. Here also, seeing that the crossing end crosses the 4 standard ends along with the plain view. Here also we are forming the Leno structure. Here the crossing end passes nearby 4 ends, over the 4 ends. While weaving, these crossing ends are lifted up for a pick in the crossing set, and then few picks are worked in the ordinary set, and again a pick is worked in the open set, followed by a few picks worked in the ordinary set. So here the ordinary set is formed in the plain view for to produce plain view. This is the second type, which is produced by using pointer drafts, which is used by pointer drag. It will give the cellular effect in its structure. The ends crossed, the crossed set two peaks, the working of peaks as follows. The crossed set two peaks and the ordinary set four peaks. Open set two peaks and ordinary set four peaks, making the total of 12 peaks per repeat. So this is the construction of Netlino fabric. So the design, draft tying arrangement as shown in here. So the P denotes the plain view ends, and S denotes the standard end, and the crossing end, a single crossing end crosses the four standard threads. Then to type two, here the standard ends form the pointer draft. The grass end form the pointer draft in its drafting system. So thank you all.